started with a shovel, I guess, on a bright autumn day, when Dad obliged, he spread stone in his driveway. We had just moved in, and in the most neighborly way, he helped Lighty spread stone in his driveway. His wife Mabel declared that it was more than an error when Dad took his shovel home with him. She said it was hers, he said it was his. That's where the property line war begins. Property line, she'd say what's yours will be mine if it ends up on my side of the property line. She'd say, stay on your own 50 feet, don't cross the property line. Lighty worked the afternoon 3 to 11. He'd pull out at 2:45. At 2:51, in the rain or hot sun, Mabel would walk the line, dragging her toy wagon. It was a red radio flyer with white rocks piled up to the brim. She'd lay each one down on the line. Then at 10:59, she'd pick them all up again from the property line. She'd say what's yours will be mine if it ends up on my side of the property line. She'd say, stay on your own 50 feet. Stay on your own 50 feet across the property line. With a nail sticking out of the end, was like a fairy tale the Grimms or Aesop might write. Yeah, she'd flail it about if you got close to the edge. Thank God her growl was so much bigger than her bite. But there were baseballs and kickballs and soccer balls and toys that often disappeared in the night. The next day she'd fire up her burn barrel, made sure we were home, and then she'd burn our toys one at a time across the property line. She'd say what's yours will be mine if it ends up on my side of the property line. She'd say, stay on your own 50 feet. Stay on your own 50 feet. Stay on your own. Sometimes Lighty would come over for coffee. We'd all pretend things were normal and fine, while Mabel would peek through her Venetian blinds, watching Lighty their side of the property line. She'd say, stay on your own 50 feet. Stay on your own 50 feet. Stay on your own 50 feet. Don't cross the property.